Oh, another alert. They just keep coming. I'm going to show you how to turn off notifications on your iPhone, but still allow certain people to get through or certain apps to communicate with you. So I'm going to create a special focus session just for a particular project that I'm doing with one other person. Now, a real bonus here is that when you set that focus time on your iPhone, that will also apply on other Mac devices as long as you are logged in using the same Apple ID. Now, all of the links on how to do this are in the description to this video below. And if you find this video helpful, then please give it a like. So go into, this works for iOS 15, turning on the focus. So we go into settings and then down to focus. Now at this point, I've got a few options here. I can just turn off do not disturb, or while I'm driving, or personal, or sleep time, turn off notifications then. But what I want to do is create a new focus, and this is a particular project that I'm working on. So I click the plus button there, and this is going to be custom. You can see that you've got other options here to do it for fitness or for reading time, custom. And I'm just going to call this my project. And it's going to be red because it's a YouTube project that I'm doing with somebody else. I'm going to hit next here. I could select an icon here. Let's not worry about that. And this is going to allow me to silence notifications. And by the way, I can do this across other devices that are logged in using the same Apple ID. So on my MacBook, it will get picked up so that anytime that I select this project focus, it's going to silence notifications except the ones that I want. Customize the focus here, and this allows me to select certain people that I want to allow notifications from. So I'll just take that person there. Now I can just allow certain people. You can have a group of contacts if you want, and then certain apps as well. And I'm going to turn off notifications for all of these, but I'm going to allow notifications just for YouTube Studio and maybe messages, just for those two. Once again, you can select your own apps if you want. So I'm happy to get notifications for those. I've got other options here too, such as how to silence those notifications, still show the notifications when my screen is locked, or dim the lock screen to make the lock screen dark, or hide the notification badges. I'm going to go with the defaults there. I get to choose the lock screen and the home screen, or both. And for that matter, I can turn these on automatically. This is really interesting. I can turn this on using smart activation, and that means that it's going to go on at either a certain time of day or a certain location, or when I'm using a particular app. And so I could do that, so I know that, hey, if I'm sitting at my laptop and it's between 12 and 2 p.m. and I'm using this app, then hey, turn on this filter, this focus. And that's almost done. But what I'm going to do now is share this across all devices. And so if I do that, then let me jump across straight to my MacBook Pro, and you'll see the focus is there as well. Okay, so I jump straight over to my MacBook Pro. I need to be logged in using the same Apple ID as I'm using on my iPhone. You can do this on your iPad as well. But I have not changed the focus on my MacBook Pro. I click on settings here, and then I go into notifications and focus. And if I click on focus here, I get to see that this project focus is there. You saw the one, and this is the project focus, and now I've got that turned on, and that's going to allow notifications only if they come from this person here. And I can turn these on automatically as well, as you saw. And when you turn that focus on your Mac, it appears straight on the iPhone as well. Okay, so now you've got the MacBook on the left and you've got your iPhone on the right. So let's turn on the focus on the iPhone, and then we'll turn it off on the Mac. To turn it on the iPhone, check the link in the description below. You want to open your control center. Now, if you've got a home button on your iPhone, that's going to be swiping from the bottom up. But otherwise, you're going to be swiping from the top right down to the center. And then as soon as I do that, you can see the focus there in the middle. So we click on that. And I can turn on the focus here, click on project, and it's on. And this signal has come up on the MacBook, project on. So let's turn it off on the MacBook. To do that, scroll right up to the top to the control center, which is along here, and we can turn the project off on the Mac, the focus off on the Mac. And I just click on it on the Mac, and that will turn it off both on the Mac and, as you can see, on the iPhone. All the links are in the description below. If you have found this helpful, then give it a like.